Hello, I'm Robin Worley, welcome to Lenscraft. It's been a while since I've covered anything in On1 Photo, so this week I'm using it to process a black and white image. Recently, I've been working on a series of misty photo images shot around the area I live, and I've been doing the black and white processing using On1 Photo. So today, I thought I'd share an example using one of these images. Now, although On1 Photo has its own RAW converter and browser, I'm going to be using it as a plugin from Photoshop. Despite this, the actual processing and filters are just the same as in the full version of On1. I created the starting image from a RAW file using Capture One, and I have that image open now in Photoshop. The next step is to duplicate the image to a new layer, which I can then convert for use with smart filters. The reason I want to apply my On1 Photo processing as a smart filter is that it retains all of my editing adjustments. If I decide later that I want to change my adjustments, I just reopen the smart filter and make the changes. With the layer converted to use smart filters, I can now launch On1 Photo effects from the Photoshop filter menu. When On1 Photo launches, it puts me in the Effects tab, but I can also switch to the other tabs if I want to. I'm now going to add a series of filters to create and then process the black and white image. The first of these is the black and white filter, which makes the initial conversion. The filter is split into four sections which control different aspects of the black and white conversion. The top section is the color response sliders, although you can also switch this to a channel mixer. Below this is the tone section, where you can adjust the image tones. We then have a toner section where you can apply split toning colours to the image. And finally, there's a film grain effect. I'll start by adjusting the colour response sliders, which control how light or dark a colour becomes when converted to black and white. When I move the slider to the right, it lightens that colour, and if I move it to the left, it darkens the colour. It can be helpful to start by moving each of the colour sliders right and left to understand their effect on the image. From this, I've worked out that I want to darken the reds, which prevents the sheep from becoming too light. I'll then lighten the yellows and greens to make the grass lighter. Finally, I'll darken the blues to make the background of the scene a little easier to see, although I am going to lighten this again in a later step. Next, I want to add a film grain effect using one of the presets in the drop-down list. I'll choose Ilford HP5 400, which is a film I sometimes shoot with when I'm using a film camera. Now, I'm not going to use the tone section of this filter because I prefer to use a separate tone enhancer filter. It has a few more controls that I find useful when processing black and white photos. I want to use this filter to emphasize the detail in some of the sheep that are nearer to the camera. To make the tone adjustments, I'll zoom in on a group of sheep so that I'm not distracted by the rest of the image. I'll then use the tone sliders to ensure there's enough contrast and detail in each of the sheep. I'll also use the detail and clarity slider to emphasize the sheep's fleece. Once I'm happy with how the sheep look, I'm going to add a mask to hide the effect from the entire scene. I can then use the brush tool set to paint in to apply the effect to the foreground sheep. The next filter I want to add is one of my favourites in On1 Photo effects, which is the glow filter. In the filter, you have an amount slider which controls the strength of the effect, as well as a halo slider to control the spread of the glow. As well as these two controls, you have a mode drop-down, which defaults to soft light. When you change the mode, you create a different glow effect. For example, switching to the screen mode also causes the image to become lighter whilst adding a glow. If you're not sure which effect to use, hover your mouse over each mode in the list to preview the effect. Now, one thing that I don't like about the glow effect is when they make shadows or dark objects appear to glow. This causes a dark halo around the area that I find distracting and a little bit ugly. The way I'm going to control this problem is using a luminosity mask on the filter. The default luminosity mask is pretty much what I want because it restricts the glow from affecting the darker areas. But I can also control this further using the window slider. By moving the black and white sliders inwards, I can restrict the glow further just to the midtones in the image. One other filter worth mentioning here is the weather effect filter, which tries to simulate different weather conditions. Now, I'm not ordinarily a fan of this type of filter, but I find it can be useful for enhancing existing weather conditions. As this is a misty scene, we could use it to add more fogs to the image. To show you what it's doing, I can set the transition slider to 0. This creates a hard edge to the effect, which we can then move up and down to position with the distance slider. The amount slider then controls the strength of the effect. Currently, this doesn't look very realistic, so I'm going to remove the effect from the foreground sheep to create more depth in the image. To do this, I'll select the mask for the filter and then the brush tool. Using a relatively hard brush edge, I can paint out the effect from the sheep. Having a hard edge to the brush helps with the accuracy. Now, I'm rushing this for the video, but you can take your time and achieve a good mask. If after painting the mask I want to blend the adjustments a little bit more, I can reduce the mask density rather than trying to do more painting. Now, that's the black and white processing complete for the image, and I can click the Done button to apply the adjustments and return to Photoshop. But the thing that I want to stress is that applying a black and white conversion filter alone won't create a good photo. This is true of whatever software you're using and isn't something that applies only to On1 Photo. The thing that will improve most black and white photos is the additional processing you apply, like the tone adjustment to bring out the detail or adding a glow effect. These can help set an image apart and make it more appealing. I hope that you've enjoyed today's video. I haven't published many On1 videos in the past, so if you'd like to see more, please let me know in the comments below. I'm Robin Worley, you've been watching LensCraft, I'll see you soon for another video.